In this third part of the series, I'll describe the process for submitting results information to clinicaltrials.gov. Topics for this session include an overview of results reporting to clinicaltrials.gov via the Protocol Registration and Results System, or PRS, including the objectives of reporting and the components of results submissions. We'll also review key points to consider when reporting results. The clinicaltrials.gov results database was designed to satisfy legal requirements for the sharing of clinical trial results information. The database aims to promote objective, standardized reporting and to facilitate good reporting practices, including publishing and regulatory guidelines. The database provides structured tabular data entry to ensure complete reporting and consistent display of data elements, and to facilitate the quality assurance review of the information submitted to clinicaltrials.gov. This consistent structure supports detailed searches of the clinicaltrials.gov database. As with registration, results are manually entered or uploaded into the PRS database for eventual posting to clinicaltrials.gov. Results can be submitted once data collection has completed for at least one primary outcome measure and for records that have been previously registered on clinicaltrials.gov. Results are posted to clinicaltrials.gov once they have undergone a review process like the one performed for registration information, meaning they must pass an automated system validation process and quality assurance review by clinicaltrials.gov staff. Result submissions include scientific information provided in four modules, including participant flow, baseline and demographic characteristics, outcome measures and statistical analyses, and adverse events. An additional module, Limitations and Caveats, provides a free text field where data submitters can provide information about considerations for interpreting the reported data. There are also two modules for administrative information, including contact information for the point of contact for the study results, and a description of any agreements between the principal investigator and the study sponsor, including ones that restrict the PI from discussing or publishing study results. The participant flow module includes a table that resembles the consort flow diagram that often serves as the first figure in a clinical trial publication. It tracks the progress of participants through the trial according to the arms or groups to which they've been assigned. An arm represents a unique experience, for example, receipt of a single intervention or of a sequence of interventions for the duration of the trial. Study-specific milestones, multiple periods, and reasons for participant dropout can all be listed. An example of how a consort flow diagram is translated into a participant flow table is shown to the left. The baseline characteristics module provides demographic and baseline data for the entire population of the trial, as well as each arm or comparison group. Age, sex, race, ethnicity, and any measures assessed at baseline that are used in the analysis of the primary outcome measures are required to be included. Examples of each type of measure are shown to the left. The outcome measures and statistical analyses module presents data by arm or comparison group and accommodates categorical, continuous, and time to event data. Examples of outcome measure and statistical analysis tables are shown to the left. Three types of outcome measures are reported in this module, including primary outcome measures, which represent the analyses of greatest importance in the study and typically include the assessment used in the power calculation. Secondary outcome measures, which are of lesser importance than the primary outcomes, but are of interest in evaluating the effect of the interventions. And other pre-specified outcome measures, which are exploratory in nature. A well-planned outcome measure specifies four levels of analysis. It identifies a domain for the analysis, in this example, anxiety, defines a specific measurement tool to explore the domain, like the Hamilton Anxiety Rating Scale, indicates a specific metric for determining an effect of the interventions, such as change from baseline, and identifies a method for aggregating collected data, like report of the proportion of participants with a greater than or equal to 50% decrease in the measured scale score. The adverse events module lists all collected events, whether anticipated or unanticipated, that result in death, are serious, or are non-serious and occurring above a frequency threshold of less than or equal to 5% in any study arm or comparison group. Examples of all three adverse events tables are shown to the left. An additional section, the study documents section, is required to be included at the time of results submission for studies with a primary completion date on or after January 18th, 2017. A full protocol and accompanying statistical analysis plan are required to be submitted, and informed consent forms must also be posted for trials that are subject to the revised common rule. The statistical analysis plan can be included as part of a single document with the protocol or as a separate document. These documents must represent all amendments approved by a human subjects review board that apply to all study locations. They must be accompanied by a cover page that indicates the official title for the study, the NCT number assigned by clinicaltrials.gov at the time of trial registration, and the date of the document version. Data submitters can redact information, including personally identifiable information and trade secrets or other confidential commercial information, unless the information is otherwise required to be submitted. The uploaded documents must be in the archival PDFA format and will be made public on clinicaltrials.gov, so they are also required to be in English. Inclusion of the informed consent form on clinicaltrials.gov is optional. However, clinicaltrials.gov is one of two federal websites that satisfy the requirement of the revised common rule that clinical trials conducted or supported by a common rule department or agency be posted on a publicly available federal website within a specific time frame. The compliance date for this provision was January 21st, 2019, and regulations.gov is the second site that satisfies the requirement. There are three main points to consider when reporting results to clinicaltrials.gov. These include the manner in which the data will be prepared for submission, the considerations needed to satisfy review criteria, and the relationship of reporting results to clinicaltrials.gov to publishing results in scientific journals. Summarizing results for submission to clinicaltrials.gov is similar in complexity to preparing results for journal publication. The process requires an understanding of the study design and analytic plan, a basic understanding of the principles of clinical trial conduct and analysis, and access to the necessary data. Ideally, results should be prepared for submission by the study's principal investigator or statistician. The submitted information must be accurate and precise, as well as understandable and informative for someone who is a reader of the medical literature, but not an expert in the field. It's recommended that someone who is not familiar with the study review the information for clarity and comprehension prior to submission to clinicaltrials.gov. It is important to note that meeting the requirements for reporting to clinicaltrials.gov does not necessitate a change in study design or study procedures. The reported results should reflect what was planned and collected as part of the study as designed to meet the research objectives. Results are intended for readers of the medical literature and not the lay public. This is different from information provided during registration, which should be understandable to a lay audience to facilitate recruitment of study participants. Results provided in data tables should be informative with minimal narrative text. Conclusions and discussion of the data are not permitted. The database is intended for report of just the facts, that is, just the summary level data, and result submission is not required for all registered trials, only those that are subject to the final rule, NIH policy, or other funding policies. The clinicaltrials.gov quality assurance team reviews records for apparent validity, meaningful entries, logic, and internal consistency, and will return a record with comments requiring the resolution of major problems when the following types of issues arise. When there is a lack of apparent validity, such as an outcome measure that reports a mean of 263 hours of sleep per day, when a description of an analysis is too vague to be meaningful, for example, when an outcome measure reports the results of a scaled assessment without sufficient information to interpret the result, when data are inconsistent with the description of the analysis, for example, when an outcome measure reports a count of participants rather than a median and full range for a time to event, when information throughout a record is inconsistent, for example, when a study designated as observational indicates that randomization was used to assign participants to interventions, or when a trial design is unclear, for example, when participants suddenly appear in an outcome measure analysis who were not included in the participant flow or baseline characteristics modules. Both clinicaltrials.gov and peer-reviewed journal publications seek to ensure accurate and informative results reporting. However, they differ in important ways. clinicaltrials.gov results reporting does not reject submissions, while peer-reviewed journals can refuse to publish research that isn't deemed high quality or of interest to readers. Clinicaltrials.gov permits the disclosure of all outcome measures that were assessed, while journals might limit the focus to the report of critical aspects of a study, thereby excluding some outcome measures. And clinicaltrials.gov does not permit extensive narrative text. It is intended for tabular, summary-level data only. In contrast, journal articles rely upon narrative text and conclusive language to provide context for reported results and to allow for interpretation of comparative analyses. In summary, the clinicaltrials.gov results database was designed to fulfill legal requirements, facilitate structured data entry, and support detailed searches of results information. Results are reported in four scientific modules that reflect the flow of participants through a study, their baseline characteristics, the results of outcome measure analyses in which they participate, and any serious adverse events, frequent non-serious adverse events, or deaths that occur over the course of the study. There are also three types of supporting documentation that can or should be appended, including the study protocol, the statistical analysis plan, and the informed consent form. Results should be prepared for submission by someone who understands the study design and analytic plan. Result submissions to clinicaltrials.gov serve to supplement journal publication by allowing report of all analyses and studies. Now I'll ask a couple of questions to review the material that we covered. True or false? Results reporting is required for all trials that have been registered on clinicaltrials.gov. This is false. Result submission is not required for registered studies that are not subject to the final rule, NIH policy, or other funding policies. True or false? When reporting results on clinicaltrials.gov, researchers can describe conclusions drawn from analyses of all pre-specified outcome measures, even ones that aren't reported in journal publications. This is false. Clinicaltrials.gov does not permit study records to include conclusive language or discussion of trial results. I hope you've learned about the types of information included in results submissions to clinicaltrials.gov and how these submissions differ from journal publications. Thank you for your attention.